In less than 3 minutes, I'll show you how to use Stable Diffusion 3 to generate images with or without ComfyUI. Before we do anything else, we need an API key. So let's get that from the Stability AI website. Go ahead and log in or create an account if you don't already have one. Create an API key and copy it. I'll show you how to use a free Google Colab Notebook. Open the Colab Notebook linked in the description and make your own copy. And open the Secrets tab. Delete any keys here and click Add a New Secret. You'll name this SD3 API in all caps. Paste your key and allow notebook access. Now hit the Run button for step 1. This will install all dependencies in the notebook. Once that's finished, run step 2 and scroll to the bottom. Click on the link and this will take you to your very own Stable Diffusion 3 generator. Update your prompts, select your aspect ratio, seed, model, style, and then hit submit. This will use the Stability API to generate the image. You'll get 25 credits to start with. Depending on the model, you'll be able to generate 3 to 6 images. The Turbo is cheaper, but the full model definitely does better with text. I created this notebook myself after lots of trial and experimentation from another GitHub repo. Now let's do the same thing in ComfyUI. Go ahead and launch your ComfyUI instance. Go to the manager and install custom nodes. You can search for Stable Diffusion 3 or Zhou to see if it's available in the manager. At this time, it's not available, so we'll install it manually using terminal. Open your terminal and change the directory to your custom nodes folder. Then clone the GitHub repository. After it's finished, open the folder and the config.json file and paste your Stability AI API key between the quotation marks. You'll now need to restart your ComfyUI and refresh your browser. Search for the Stable Diffusion 3 node, paste in your prompts, and select your settings. You can choose your aspect ratio, the model, you can fix your seed, and set your denoise strength for the image. And if you want to do text to image or image to image. Here I'm feeding in an image by loading it, and you'll see that it has changed the aspect ratio. Let's do one more run. Let's create a new sign from text to image and see if it can handle multiple text outputs. The full model definitely produces better results, but it's far from being perfect. And you'll most likely need a few tweaks and credits to get the image you're looking for. And that's pretty much it. Let us know what you think of the new models in the comments below. If you're out of the loop with what's going on at Stability AI, click here.